Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about DAX query view. What it is, when to use it, once you use it, what are the benefits you're going to get. That's what we're going to see as part of this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So the main purpose of this DAX query view is to improve the productivity. And when you have a direct query mode, now people cannot see the data unless they go to the source or they need to use the tabular editor external tools. Now using this DAX query view, direct query mode users, if the model is in direct query, they can able to see the data. The third benefit you are going to get is like see multiple measures at once in the editor. Basically, like there will be like dependent measures. Let's say a quick example, you have a sales measure, sales amount, and you have a YTD, MTD, QTD defined. So sales measure is the base measure, YTD, MTD uses that sales amount measure. So you can see all together. There can be multiple hierarchy like this. I have seen like seven levels or 3 to 4 levels of measures, one dependent on other, right? So these kind of measures, you can see it at once in this DAX query view. So troubleshooting, basically this is all about troubleshooting. When your report is not you're not getting the output for the table or whatever visuals you are viewing in the Power BI, you want to troubleshoot what is going wrong, then you can troubleshoot in this view. So this is all about it. And one last thing, an important thing, is like this DAX query view is like a SQL query, in that you can use it to view data in your model. What I think is like why DAX is so complex and people cannot able to improve, a lot of talks about that. And the one of the major disadvantages, like we don't have environment to practice DAX within the model or outside. This we need to go for external tools. People are not going for it. So Power BI team has brought this as part of that Power BI desktop itself, so that whoever is author, they can use DAX queries similar to SQL query to that, so that they can troubleshoot or they can practice the DAX and they can able to evaluate the results. That is the one of the major purpose for introducing this DAX query view as part of Power BI desktop. That's what I feel. So these are the different purposes, and you can have benefits once you start using it DAX query view. This channel contains a free content that covers a Power BI from DAX and Power BI services. You can learn about Power BI, Power Query, and much more about it. And also covers SQL basics and data warehousing, SSIS and SSIS as well. Please share this channel with your friends and colleagues. With this note, let's begin our today's topic with a practical demo. So I'm in Power BI now, Power BI desktop basically. Now you can see here there is another tab, or you can call it as a blade, appears here, that is DAX query view. And this has still in a preview feature, and it is introduced in November release, I think. So you ensure you have a latest version of Power BI desktop. If you're not getting it, just go to File, Options and Settings, Options, and then you can click on the option that is a preview features in this global. Then you can choose this option, that is DAX query view. I have already enabled it, I'm not doing it. If you're trying it for the very first time, you need to close the Power BI desktop and then reopen it again after checking that option. So coming to explanation about this DAX query view, what are the purpose, let's go and check it out. So there are two things over here. Importantly, you can see by default it gives us some evaluate table, evaluate top in 100 of sales, which means like these are the simple DAX query which gives 100 rows of sales table. Let's try to run this. So this is the mandatory part. Always DAX queries will run. It's like a select star from. Okay, that is what you need to simply remember. Evaluate is nothing but evaluate of the result. Whatever table you are going to query, the result of the, your query will be displayed. Evaluate is like a select star from, but it is not exactly, it may not be exactly the same, but this is mandatory syntax. On top of that, you can define a lot of measures as well. So define is optional, but evaluate is a mandatory thing. Now, how I can see this table is like, I mean, the DAX query view, how it's going to improve my productivity. Let me try to give you example. Always when I have a SQL server, I am from a database background. So whenever I see a table, I want to query or filter the tables. So let me try to query this table, sales, right? I want to filter this instead of, I can filter it here using this view. Instead of this, I want to check how many online orders are available, right? So let's try to do it in a DAX query view. Let me clear this one, select all. So how many online, let's see the value online order, and the column name is order type name. Let's go and check it out. So let me try to write evaluate is a mandatory thing. I always like this filter as one kind of, it will return a table, right? So it will display it here, sales and order type name. Order type name equals online order. Let's close this and evaluate. There you go. You can see a list of results, that is 328 rows. So I can see what are the online orders here. This is the same thing, you're going to do it over here, right? So when I press online order, then you can able to see it, 328 results. But when you have to familiar with what you call DAX queries, you need to start practicing it here. And as I already told, this is not possible when you have a direct query view. Direct query view, this table view tab itself won't be available for them. Right now they can write this query, then they can see the results as well. This is another advantage. So this is how you can able to practice, or you can check your data using the DAX queries. So this is one simple example. What are other features available? Let's try to brainstorm it. Like when I have this query, let's take a simple example, sales amount. I have this query, right? In only in this view, okay, that in this tab you will get this query, quick queries, define and evaluate. When you go to table view or model view, when you check this data and when you click, right click on this table, I don't think you get that query options here. Okay, so that is the difference. So you ensure you are in this DAX query view. So right click, and then I mean, it's not a right click, it's just a click of the three dots, and then you can define and evaluate. So now I am seeing this query, I'm in this measure formula here, that is define measure, and then I can able to see the results as well. What is the total sales amount? I can able to manipulate it or do whatever calculations I want, amend it. So one of the beautiful feature here is, let's say I'm trying to add some 100, right? 100 on top of the sales amount for every transaction or the total output. Let's say 571920, right? So this is the total calculation. I can run this one right now. So instead of 200, I get 300. Or I can consider instead of the sales amount, I want to include in the sales amount the tax amount as well, right? So what is the tax amount? Sum of tax. Okay. Sum of sales amount, tax amount. What is the tax amount? I don't think I have a tax amount here. Just forgot about it. Let's try to add a simple example. Like I want to double this tax amount, so I am adding it again. So just sum of sales amount, comma sum of sales amount. So when I run this one, it is doubled right now. So basically this is the where you can play around with your measures, and immediately you can see I changed the definition of this measure. It will not reflect it here, okay, but there is a provision for me, there is a privilege for me to update this measure definition. Let's try to update it. So update in the model. Now when I go back to this measure, you see the sum of sales amount is doubled. So this is what I'm saying. So now even you can revert it back. Now I'm reverting it. Okay, so this is like you have defined a lot of measures and you want to update it quick manner with different approaches, because what happens is like how it improves the productivity is like when you change the measure earlier, when you have it is a very big model, right? It takes a lot of time to validate here and to update the entire visuals over in the page, and it takes a lot of time. But I think the DAX query view is somewhat more productive and it is very quicker. It is separated from the model, that I'm pretty much not sure, but it is way quicker than the traditionally we used to update the measure. So this is one of the advantage. Then the second thing I want to highlight is like the dependencies measures, right? So let's say this MTD measure, let's see the definition of it. MTD measure, so total MTD, sum of sales quantity. Now I think December 1, this one I can take. So basically this is like I'm defining the December month salary alone, sales amount alone. So this is the December month and this is the year selected, and I'm using the sales amount, that is the calculated measure. Okay, so when I go here, I use this sales month amount December, and I can use the, instead of define and evaluate, this time I'm going with define with reference and evaluate. So now you can see here what happens. This is the second level of measure, which is referring the base measure, that is the sales amount. This is the next prior to this. This should be calculated first in order to calculate sales amount, because this is being referenced here. So both will be appearing here. So this is the very big challenge when you have a multiple reference. This measure refers to this one, this measure refers to another measure, like this. Usually in a complex model, we usually define in a reference measures. So for troubleshooting that, we need to change one measure and checking other measures, it become very complex. Earlier we used to change the measure and then we drag and drop all these measures. Let's say I use this one and also this one in the chart or some cards like this, then we change the measure and check the value it's appearing or not. But here this is also fine, but as I said, it took long time or takes time to troubleshoot, or it takes more time performance wise. But in this DAX query view, without changing the measure, because here what the risk of is, right, you can able to overwrite it without, you don't know what's happening or what is going on. Once you change it, whether it's old value, you have written a formula, right, initially, then you have written another formula and you forget what you have written. So whether the previous formula, you don't know what it was, so it will be very difficult to troubleshoot for you. So in this case, you still hold different views and you can still store it what has happening. So that is the one of the advantages I can see. So in this way, there are a lot of benefits as a report author or DAX query author, you can able to get it. So once you change it, only if you wish it can able to change it, then you can update the measure. So here you can see like each and every measure gets its own update statement. If you see here, now when I, after changing it, the update model appears here. Otherwise, this base measure won't get any of the update, but this measure will get the update model override measure, since you are coming from this the child measure, right? Because here I'm going to perform define and reference with and evaluate. That is why only update model for override measure for this measure is appearing here. So any changes you do, then you can able to update it. I hope these are the some of the advantages of this DAX query view. Along with that, if you see like any measure is having any performance issues, there is option right now run in DAX query view. Earlier you have only copy query, you can copy it and check what is happening in tabular editor. Right now you can click from here, it will open up in the new query window, then you can troubleshoot what is going wrong. So these are the advantages of this DAX query view. I hope now people can start using DAX query view. It's like similar to writing SQL queries in SSMS or any of the client tools. Within Power BI Desktop itself, Microsoft has enabled this DAX query view. So people will start writing DAX queries to have more knowledge on DAX. Definitely it's going to improve the performance in my in productivity. So I hope in soon we will see more DAX ninjas in the future. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.